DoorDash drivers, this is why white folks don't tip you. I'm waiting for the comments and the smoke. You ever been driving in a nice neighborhood? There are nice black neighborhoods, there are nice white predominantly neighborhoods, there are white all races neighborhoods, but we talk about one that don't have any black people there. And you thinking to yourself, oh, I'm going to get some big tips. That's what you think in your head. Like, yeah, all I see is white people walking around, watering their lawn, different flags on the line, different presidential candidates on the line. You thinking, oh yeah, this is gonna be a good tip. But guess what? That's not gonna happen, bruh. We're talking about people who haven't tipped in the beginning of the app. And you know, it's like, okay, cool. I'm gonna get a tip on top of this. That's what you tell yourself. Like, look at these houses. You see three-car garages, and I'm talking about places like Buckhead. I'm talking about Calabasas. I'm talking about Thousand Oaks. When you see crazy three-car garages, four-car garages, you're like, oh yeah, this tip's gonna be good. Even if they tipped a little bit, they're gonna think about it for a second like, you know what? Go ahead and throw a $20 tip on there for them. Guess what? You're not gonna get it. That's right. White people don't like tipping either. You got a $12 order of Chick-fil-A. That's like a number one with a cookie. Oh, taking it to this guy, fancy house, I get it. Nice neighborhood, nothing but white people walking around with AKC dogs that you only see in TV on ESPN. Like, oh man, that's a Labradoodle. When I go to these predominantly white neighborhoods, I'm like, that's what a Labradoodle looks like? Like, I never see these show dogs until I go to an all predominantly white neighborhood. Like, wow, they got $3,000 dogs. They got dogs you never heard of. White people buy dogs from overseas, get them shipped over here. Like, you, what is that? They have, oh, I got somebody from Australia. This is an Australian cattle dog. Australian cattle dogs don't live in the United States, just in case you don't know that. All right, they come from Australia. All right, straight up, like straight up Australian cattle dog. I ain't seeing that in other neighborhoods, not just black, all right? Not just Asian, not just Mexican. I'm just saying, especially in Mexican neighborhood, I ain't seen no Australian cattle dog. I ain't pull up to no Mexican neighborhood, be like, hey, yo, ¿qué pasó? So with that Australian cattle dog. But you guys are arguing with me in the comments about, yo, man, you don't know nothing about this perspective. I'm only speaking from experience, all right? I'm only just keeping it real. I'm keeping it real. All right, I'm giving you the 100 experience going on right now. Don't assume that white people means they're going to spend money on you. Don't be that dumb driver out here. Anybody can give you money for a tip, and anybody cannot give you money for a tip. Everybody argue me in the comments. It's mostly white people talking about I shouldn't tip you. That's what I'm talking about. That's the thing I'm talking about right now. White people arguing with me in the comments about how they shouldn't tip. That explains why white people won't tip. So don't assume just because you're in an all-white neighborhood that they're gonna make it rain on you. You need to think about this. The next video is why black people don't tip. Make sure you check out the whole series, fam. Join the conversation down below. If you're a driver, let me know. Tell me some stories about you getting tips in a white neighborhood, or tell me some stories about you assuming that you thought you was gonna get a tip just because the neighborhood was predominantly white. Am I white?